So you're working in Articulate Studio, and you're thinking of moving your project to Storyline. But perhaps you're worried that all of your hard work in Studio will be lost. Well, worry not, my friends, because the transition process is wonderfully smooth. Let me show you. I'm here in Studio, and I have a fairly standard PowerPoint deck. I have a menu slide, and on this menu slide I have some transparent rectangles that are hyperlinked out to individual content slides. In turn, each of these content slides have shapes that then hyperlink back to the main menu slide. This is a fairly standard interactive menu build that we would see in Studio. Other items of note that we'll pay attention to here to see how they transfer over into Storyline, I have some stylized shapes here, which if we go and take a look at, we have two gradient stops on these shapes. So we'll see how those transfer over to Storyline. If we go to our slide master, I've got some slide masters that I've built out with simple images in the background. If I go to my slide properties area here, this is a good one. I've labeled all of my slides and I've set them all to advance by user. Also, to take a look at how animations come over, each of the text boxes on the content slides have been given a simple fade animation, and using Articulate's sync animation tool, I've gone ahead and have them syncing in at roughly 1/2 second into the timeline. Finally, I've added a Quizmaker slide here at the end for demonstration purposes. Now, the process to move everything over into Storyline, very straightforward. Here in Storyline, all I have to do is select the Articulate A button, Import, PowerPoint, navigate to the PowerPoint I wish to import, select Open, and my slides are going to appear here in front of me, and now I can simply import them into my project. While this is happening, Storyline is working some magic behind the scenes. It's analyzing each of those slides. It's looking for shapes, those gradients that I've added. It's looking for animation timings. It's looking at the slide masters. It's looking at those hyperlinks so that it can get us set up for this smooth transition. I'm going to let Storyline finish its work here and continue in a moment. After the import process is finished, we start off here in the story view of Storyline, and from this view, we're going to see a lot of our work already transferring over. If I select my menu slide here, these arrows indicate that there are hyperlinks jumping out to the individual content slides, and if I select a content slide, we see an arrow jumping back to the menu slide. This means that those hyperlinks that we created are here and they are active. Now, we also had gone into the slide properties area and labeled our slides, and we see that the slide labels have indeed come on over to Storyline. We also wanted these slides to advance by the user, and if we draw our attention over to the right-hand side, we see that all of these slides indeed do advance by user. So that work we know has already come over. If I come down to my menu slide here, we see that our transparent rectangles have transferred over wonderfully, and in fact, Storyline has taken those hyperlinks and transferred those into triggers for us. It's a big time saver. Also, those stylized shapes. If we take a look at that, we see that those two gradient stops have also transferred over as well. So, visually, everything that we've created in Studio looks great over here in Storyline. Our slide masters will have transferred over beautifully. There they are, ready to go for us. What about those animations? Remember, we had animations, we had fade-ins at roughly 1/2 second. We have this fade-in, and if we look at the timeline, they are coming in at roughly 1/2 second. So all that hard work we put in is paying off. Our Quizmaker slide has transferred over beautifully. Now you'll notice there is a white border around the outside. This is because the aspect ratio for Quizmaker is different than that which I chose for my Storyline project, but this is a simple fix. If I so chose, I could go in to the slide master and make this shape fill the white border, but I kind of like the look, so I think I'm going to leave it just like that. Now I have done absolutely nothing here in terms of changing what's going on, so if I preview this scene, if we want to find out, does that functionality carry over? What we're going to find is that indeed it does. If I come down here and select, I should go to my solar heating slide. It fades in, and now I should be able to go back. Beautiful. Absolutely wonderful. The transition has been smooth. All of my functionality has carried over. And now if I chose, I could come in here and start leveraging some of Storyline's interactive objects to add more contextual information to my course. I love it. So, if you're thinking of moving your project from Studio to Storyline, don't hesitate. All of your hard work is going to pay off once you get to Storyline.